described in captioned media program. In the classroom and online, dcmp.org.
Alexander Street Press presents The Mystery of Sleep.
People who tend to have a lot of nightmares are people who are unusually open, vulnerable in a sense.
Sleep study x-rays. A man awakes and hits his pillow in a brainwave pattern on graph paper.
When you think of it that we spend one-third of our lives sleeping and we don't know why we spend one-third of our lives that way, it just is an extraordinary mystery.
A title appears, The Mystery of Sleep. With a full moon behind, thin white clouds float past. Now an image of Paul McCartney playing his guitar.
The melody of Paul McCartney's famous song, Yesterday, came to him in a dream. Upon waking, he rushed to play it on a piano before the melody could slip away from him.
An old photo of a man with dark curly hair and beard.
Charles Dickens believed that the position of his bed was essential to a good night's sleep. He insisted that it always face north.
A color painting of a man in a white powdered wig.
Benjamin Franklin thought it would be a luxury to have two beds, so that if he awoke in a hot bed, he could move to one that was cool and fresh. Sarah Bernhardt, the famous French actress, sometimes slept in a coffin, claiming it helped her prepare for her many tragic roles.
Several images of people sleeping indoors and outdoors.
Sleep, that complicated state of being. Throughout the ages, until the 20th century, so little was known about the subject that sleep was generally understood as a time when both the body and the brain were in a complete state of rest.
An elderly man in a suit and beret.
Then this man created a revolution in the way we think about sleep. His name was Nathaniel Kleitman. He immigrated to the United States in 1915 and obtained a PhD in psychology from the University of Chicago in 1923. He was one of a handful of men interested in learning about the mechanisms of sleep.
I told the head of the department, the chairman, that I was interested in sleep. He said, I'm interested too. Go ahead and do whatever you want to, but nobody's going to guide you or tell you what to do.
Black and white news footage.
By chance, an early newsreel filmed an aspect of his research.
Bruce Richardson on the bunk and Dr. Nathaniel Kleitman have been studying the cycle of sleep to see if man without daylight can abandon the seven-day week.
Dr. Kleitman.
We have come here to make observations on the physiology of sleep. A part of his study has been going on at the University of Chicago since 1922.
If the experiment helps us to sleep better these hot nights, we vote for science.
In a dark cave, Kleitman shakes the hands of people carrying lanterns.
In 1952, now a professor at Chicago University.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deaf-blind. These services include a library of free-loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approved lists of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.